welcome back to REV. Earlier today, we showed you some of the many cars on display at the World Trade Center. But now we're here at the SM Expo Convention Center to see more of MIAS 2024. Newer cars that's set to enter our Philippine market in just a few months is this. This is Seres. Now, Seres is a China-based car company that's set to have so many cars available for the market. Now, believe it or not, these particular rides right here, they do have an average range of 500 kilometers to at least 1,200 kilometers, depending on the variant you get, whether you get the hybrid or whether you get the EV. And it's a wide selection of SUVs that's catered just for everybody. We're going to be seeing more about this, but time to take a look at Seres. So we're here right now at Omoda and Jayco, and in this booth, a lot of things actually happen throughout this day. And with me, of course, is Sir Uzi. Uzi, you know, thank you very much for having
us. Thank you.
And first things first, though, a lot of people aren't familiar with your two brands, Omoda and Jayco. Give us an overview. What is it?
First, Omoda and Jayco is very new. That's why probably a lot of people don't know about it. The global launch was just last year. And the brand is very aggressive and expanding globally. Omoda is more of the young and trendy and fashionable, while Jayco is more focusing on the outdoor, rugged, high lifestyle. That's the theme of the two brands.
Pretty nice, pretty nice. And you know, with Omoda and Jayco being a new brand, a lot of people are going to have some concerns, but how does the brand aim to handle any of those concerns or misconceptions that it might carry?
First, we have three things. Number one, we're a global brand. I've already said this. Number two, we put extra emphasis on customer safety. People might think that cars from from China might not be of good quality or something, but Omoda and Jayco actually undergoes stringent testing. We have our own NVH lab, our own crash test lab, even before we subject it to external accreditations. That's why our Omoda 5 garnered a 5-star rating and a 5-star rating for Euro NCAP, ASEAN NCAP, and Australian NCAP. The most, the strictest accrediting bodies for safety. There. Yeah, so yeah, you know, some other Chinese brands can't even hit 2 or 3 stars, but we're proud to say that 5 stars.
Thanks.
And the last one is warranty and the finish of the car. We will be offering 10 years engine warranty or 1 million kilometers.
Wow.
And bumper to bumper, 7 years. And for our EV, 8 years for the battery, electric motor, and module, and or 200,000 kilometers. That's how confident we are.
So earlier today, we spent the first half of Manila International Auto Show at the World Trade Center. Right now, we're here at SMX to see the rest of the other cars on display. Let's check it out first with what's going on with MG.
We bring two new officially launched EVs, ZS EV and the MG4 X Power, and the other three of the order pre-order taking. That is also EV products, and it already shows the development or innovation on the technology and also cutting-edge designing. This is really coming back. We can very easily feel that this is really what MG should be look like.
That's right.
What is in our energy about sporty drive of the fun? That's it. So this is, I think, in the next several years, we will definitely focus on our electrifying, our mobility, and also we will still take care of our ICE products. Because I think with the development, you can very easily see, like MG7, yeah. RX9, it's already the next generation of the ICE products. At the same time, when we are developing our EV products, we are also trying our best to improve our ICE products to fulfill all kinds of customers' expectations.
And you know, there's so much promise with MG right now, especially with how the brand is moving toward.
Yeah.
And initially, though, a lot of people are still concerned, though. It's ICE versus EV. A lot of people are worried about that, right? Especially since there is still a lack of infrastructure. How does the brand aim to help solve those issues?
To my opinion, for the long-term point of view, ICE will still be very strong in Philippine market. But ICE or BEV products is definitely the future. So in MG Philippines, we definitely will have the good combination to develop the proposed ICE product and the EV product. To my opinion, within the next 3 years, in the Philippine market, we will still focus on at least 80% on the ICE product and 20% on the new introduction of the EV product.
Talking about intelligent electrification. What does MG mean with that?
So I think, as you know, MG is one of the pioneers of electrification here in the country. And of course, the technology of NG coming from our British heritage has also translated in our vehicles here. And then those vehicles, we are bringing it here in the country. And of course, we are reinforcing our strength in the EV space.
Now everyone's adjusting to MG. There might be some misconceptions about the brand, which is normal, right? But how does the brand aim to handle any misconceptions whatsoever?
I think for a misconception, it's very much normal for any growing brand, and MG is no exception to it, right? MG has been here in the Philippines. The brand itself has been here in the Philippines for the past 5 years, and I think it has already gained traction to the Filipino customers. We have a lot of MG enthusiasts. We are still a growing brand, and I think for this year, that is one of our biggest goals, is to really try to become closer, make our customers more aware that MG brand is here and we have product offerings that fits any of the lifestyle of our Filipino families, Filipino community.
That's really exciting. You know, like I myself am personally excited to get behind the wheel of any of these cars.
You have already?
You better stay tuned for our review of the Cyberster. Apart from the display of automobiles, MIA has also featured a wide array of exhibits and activities for car enthusiasts and non-enthusiasts alike. Interactive displays, live demonstrations, and test driving experiences for some cars. With everything that's been shown at this year's Manila International Auto Show, it's pretty clear to see how positive and forward-looking the world of mobility will look like for everyone. So much new tech to consider on your next move. And although the change might feel daunting to some, the idea of having such a large and supportive community can also be comforting for anyone moving from conventional tech to new tech.